Our top story tonight, with a new year comes new driving laws. One of them is aimed at making the roads much safer and keeping drunk drivers off the streets, with a zero tolerance law for those already convicted of a DUI. Meantime, a dozen Salinas police officers set up this DUI and driver's license checkpoint earlier tonight at the Westridge Shopping Center. They say they're stepping up patrols, especially now during the holiday season with all the partying and celebrating going on. Action News reporter Stephanie Truong is live in Salinas with more on their efforts and the new DUI law.
Well, Aaron, yeah, the DUI checkpoint here wrapped up about an hour ago. Salinas police say no DUI arrests made, so successful. But they also say that wasn't the major goal for tonight. It was really to send a clear warning to those who plan on drinking and driving for New Year's celebrations tomorrow night.
Goes to my mind, or as well, could I have hurt somebody?
For nearly two decades, Tony Harris drank.
I was constantly, if I was behind the wheel, I had a beer between my legs.
Harris is now a counselor for the Sun Street Center's DUI program, but he drank so much, he spent about 5 years in jail for DUIs and even fell into what's known as blackout driving.
I've had it where I ran into telephone poles and taken fences out and things like that, but I've also driven where I left Salinas, for instance, and ended up in Santa Cruz and did not remember the drive. So I don't know if I hurt anybody, hit anybody, or what.
Now a new zero-tolerance law going into effect January 1st, 2009 is aimed at preventing drunk drivers with a history of DUIs from getting behind the wheel.
We also want to make people very aware of that. If they have any prior convictions for drunk driving, there's absolutely no alcohol at all in their system when they're driving.
At two drinks, you put yourself at risk. Your ability to control your vehicle is altered. And people die as a result of drinking and driving.
If those on DUI probation refuse to take the breathalyzer or fail the test with at least a 0.01 blood alcohol content level, they will be cited, their licenses will be suspended, and their cars impounded.
I think it's great. I wish they can do more. I think it could be stiffer because, I mean, like I said, it took me a lot. You know, the fines didn't stop me. You know what I mean? So it's going to take something a lot stricter and tougher than what we have.
Salinas police out enforcing a DUI checkpoint Tuesday night agree it takes more than just law enforcement.
It's public education, you know, and it's friends, keeping friends from driving. That's going to be our biggest asset in this whole thing.
For Harris, it was his young nephew who he says saved his life and possibly others.
Uncle Tony hit tears in his eyes. I want you back. I miss you. I don't like you like this. And that did it.
Now, according to the latest Avoid the 18 campaign in Monterey County, 114 DUI arrests were made between Thanksgiving weekend and December 12th. That's a 32% increase from last year. But that good news is that there were no fatalities. And Aaron, to keep that trend going, police are really encouraging people, if you're going to be going out and celebrating, that's fine. Just make sure you either take a cab or have a designated driver to make sure everyone gets home safely.
All right, Stephanie, thank you.